Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding an important topic, that is functions of management. What are the different functions of management? Last class we have seen regarding the principles of management and regarding what is management. Today we are going to discuss regarding functions of management. Before moving to the topic, you should know there is no universally accepted functions of management, because different authors has given their views according to the different types. There is no universally accepted functions of management. Still, the most important or most widely accepted functions of management is given by Luther Gulick, that is post de Kolb. It's a mnemonic, post de Kolb. It means P stands for planning, O stands for organizing, S stands for staffing, D stands for directing, and CO stands for coordination, R stands for reporting, and B stands for budgeting. Here, R and B, that is reporting as well as budgeting, will comes under controlling. Reporting means it is a written or oral communication between two staffs. Okay, it's a written or oral communication between two staffs. That is reporting. And budgeting means it's a financial plan in terms of money, numerical expression. It is a financial plan of an organization. Got it? That in next classes I will explain in detail regarding reports and budget and all. Now you have to keep it in mind, reports and budget will comes under controlling. Got it? So you can classify the functions of management as planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, and coordination. So this R and B comes under controlling. Got it? Let's see one by one. First one is planning. What is mean by planning? Planning means deciding in advance. Before you are introducing a thing or you are implementing a thing, you are making a plan or you are going to make a plan before introducing the thing. Got it? I will give you the example. Suppose your college day celebration is going to come. First of all, you will plan, no? Like that in any organization, to start a new thing or a new department, whatever it may be, you have to plan. So what are the things is happening in planning? We can see the things that is happening in planning is making the objectives, making the policies, and making a time limit. That is what to do, when to do, where to do, how to do, and who is going to do. You will make a plan, you will have a time limit, and you will have the objectives, and you will have the policies. Okay, suppose you are going to start a new college or a new department in the college, you will make a plan first. That is mean by planning. Planning means deciding in advance. Okay, next one is organizing. Organizing means it's the developing a system. You are developing a system. Organizing means you are developing a system. What are the things you will develop in organizing? Physical resources as well as human resources. That is material as well as man. Human resource and physical resource. So what are the things you will do in organizing means identifying the jobs. You will identify the jobs and you will divide the jobs. Okay. And you will define the responsibilities of each job for each positions. You will identify the job. You will divide the job. You will define the responsibilities of each job. And you will give the responsibility to the different staffs, as well as you will give the authority. Got it? So identifying the job and dividing the job, as well as you are defining the responsibilities and job descriptions, right? That's regarding organizing. Next one is staffing. Staffing means you are selecting. After organizing, you are selecting the required staff. It is an important component of an organization. You need good staffs. Suppose you have so many materials are there. You have nice lab, nice computer is there, but there is no manpower, means you should need a nice staff. So in staffing, the things that is happening is recruitment, selection, orientation, skill training and evaluation. So you have to select the staff. How to select the staff? Through recruitment. Recruitment means it is a process of finding, it is a process of finding the employees for the work. You are trying to find out the employees for the work and you will select the required employees. Afterwards, you will give the orientation regarding the policies and protocols of your institution. You will give the orientation. Got it? Then you have to give the skill training. You have to give the skill training, means the skill training include in service education or continuing education. You have to give to the staff. Finally, you have to evaluate their performance also. Got it? That comes under staffing. So proper staffing should be there in an organization. Next one is directing. Directing means you are giving instruction to your subordinates. You are giving instructions to your subordinate. So who is your subordinate? The person who is working under you. You are giving the instruction. So what are the things happening in directing means? Supervision, communication, motivation and leadership. You will supervise them. You will observe their work. That is mean by supervision. You will observe the work of the subordinates, whether they are working according to the policies of the organization. So you will observe them and you will communicate with them. You will exchange your ideas to them. You will give instruction to them and you will motivate them. You will reinforce them. Okay. Then you have to lead them. You are a leader. You are leading them. That is the function of directing. Got it? Next one is controlling. Controlling means you are measuring the performance of the staff. You are evaluating the performance of the staff. In their quantity of work as well as their quality of work, you are evaluating. Got it? Then you will take corrective actions if required. If at all required, you will take the corrective action and you will compare the performance of the staff. You will have a standard. That is, you will have an expectance that this staff will perform like this or this staff should perform like this. So according to that, you will compare whether he has reached to that level or not. If at all not reached, you can improve his performance. You can correct the problem. So that is happening in controlling. Got it? Next one is coordination. Coordination means it's a cooperation between the departments or the cooperation between the staff working together. There should be a coordination or a cooperation between the departments. Then only the smooth running of the organization will occur. Right? So for a smooth running of the organization, coordination is very necessary between the staff as well as between the different departments. Got it? That's regarding functions of management. So you have to keep it in mind. Always the mnemonic, that is post D co. Okay, and one by one you can see P for planning, O for organizing, S for staffing, D for directing, CO for coordination, R for reporting, B for budgeting. Got it? But reporting and budgeting comes under controlling. So you can explain in this manner. This is the simple techniques of functions of management. Got it? That's all regarding today's topic. If you have any suggestion, please comment below and we will meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.